No, we don't have a program. We have no idea what we're doing. Yes. Sorry? We are filming, yes. Sorry? Okay, that's all right. He can come back. That's not a problem. Croeso I gwasanaeth I coded faned a dydd gwyl dewi. A dydd gwyl dewi hapus I chi gyd. Welcome to our flag raising ceremony on this St. David's Day, and a very happy St. David's Day to you all. We meet on the traditional lands of the Wurundjeri people and pay our respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging. Before we carry on, let me just do the housekeeping. Oh, welcome to everybody at home. We just do the housekeeping, please. Social distance as much as you possibly can. Masks while singing. The only time not to have a mask, please, is when somebody is actually talking. What else is there? Leave through the side door, please. There will be refreshments out the side there at the end of the service. And again, please maintain social distance, but there is no need for masks when we're outside. So that's always a good thing. It seems to be said a lot at the moment, but this is an unusual service in unusual times. So thank you all for those who've joined us here at church and those who've joined us watching at home. It's lovely to see you all. It would be remiss of me to start St. David's Day without just saying Wales 40, England 24. I won't say any more than that, other than to say just that. Let's start with a short prayer. Let us pray. Diolch, diolch am Gymru. Diolch am lad, am dir, am iaith. Diolch, diolch am Iesu, am ei gariad, am ei waith. Dyma weddi dydd gwyl dewi. De a gogledd, canwch can. Boed I Gymru gan i'r Iesu cadw'n calon and calon lan. Thank you for Wales, thank you for our country, our land and our language. Thank you for Jesus, his love and work. Thank you for St. David's Day. North and South will sing this song. Let us in Wales and all over the world love Jesus and join together and sing with a pure heart. Amen. Gadewch ni gannu hefo gyda'n gilydd hefo Calon Lan yr emyn Calon Lan. Let's sing together our first hymn, Calon Lan. The words will be on the screen, but I don't think you'll need them.
It's a comedy show, you know that, right? Yes, now we got it. Our first reading is from 1 Thessalonians, the second chapter. We had courage in our God to declare to you the gospel of God in spite of great opposition. For our appeal does not spring from deceit or impure motives or trickery, but just as we have been approved by God to be entrusted with the message of the gospel, even so we speak, not to please mortals, but to please God, who tests our hearts. As you know, and as God is our witness, we never came with words of flattery or with pretext for greed. Nor did we seek praise from mortals, whether from you or from others, though we might have made demands as apostles of Christ. But we were gentle among you, like a nurse tenderly caring for her own children. So deeply do we care for you that we are determined to share with you not only the gospel of God, but also our own selves, because you have become very dear to us. You remember our labor and toil, brothers and sisters. We worked day and night so that we might not burden any of you while we proclaim to you the gospel of God. You are witnesses, and God also, how pure, upright, and blameless our conduct was towards you believers. As you know, we dealt with each one of you like a father with his children, urging and encouraging you, and pleading that you should lead a life worthy of God, who calls you into his own kingdom and glory. Our second reading is in Welsh and English, and is Psalm 96, verses 1 through 7, read by Christine and Peter.
Psalm 96, adnodau 1 i 7. Canwch gân newydd i'r arglwydd, a ddeiar gyfan, canwch i'r arglwydd. Canwch i'r arglwydd, canmolwch ei enw, a dweud bob dydd sut mae e'n achub. Dwedwch wrth y cynhedloedd mor wych ydy e, wrth yr holl bobloedd am y pethau rhyfeddol mae'n ei wneud. Mae'r arglwydd yn ddiw mawr ac yn heiddi ei foli. Mae'n heiddi ei barchu fwy na diwiau eraill i gyd. Ei linod diwerth ydy diwiau'r holl bobloedd, ond yr arglwydd wnaeth greu yn efoedd. Mae ei sblander a'i urddas yn amlwg. Mae ei gryfder a'i harddwch yn ei deml. Dewch, bobl y cynhedloedd, cyhoeddwch, cyhoeddwch mor wych ac mor gryf ydy'r arglwydd.
Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord the whole earth. Sing to the Lord and bless his name. Proclaim the good news of his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations and wonders among all peoples. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. He is more to be feared than all gods. As for all the gods of the nations, they are but idols, but it is the Lord who made the heavens on the majesty and the magnificence of his presence. Oh, the power and splendor of his sanctuary. Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord honor and power.
We are here to celebrate St. David's Day and share with our fellow Welsh people, not just here, but around the world, on this special day, St. David's Day. We make a huge fuss of St. David's Day. We put on our Gamanda Gani yesterday, which I don't know how many of you saw. It's still on YouTube, and it was, well, I thought it was a great success, and people who've talked to me have said that they really enjoyed it, which was good. And I want to thank everybody, especially, we're on the lectern. They're not looking at me. Look at me. There we go. Now it is. Anyway, there we go. What was I saying? Oh, those people at home who helped put our Gaman Bagani together. Thank you very, very much. Diolch yn fawr o galon unwaith eto. We do talk about St. David's Day and we talk about St. David. Who was he? Who was this man that we call St. David? Well, most of what we know about St. David comes from an 11th century book called Bythag Dewi, The Life of Dewi, written by Rhugavarch, who was the Bishop of St. David's. He claims the book was written using documents found during the renovation of St. David's Cathedral in around 1091. The tradition says that David was born in either Henfynnw in Ceredigion or Caerfai in South Wales, around 501 AD. He was the son of a nun called Non, and was the grandson of Ceredig ap Cynedda, the king of Ceredigion. So he had a pretty good pedigree. There is very little recorded of his early life, but he was renowned as a teacher and a preacher, and he traveled far and wide, founding monasteries in places like modern-day France, Devon, Cornwall, all over Wales, and most notably in Glastonbury and St. David's in Pembrokeshire. He and his monks lived very, very austere lives. They were allowed no farm animals to do their work. If they had a plow to pull, they had to pull it themselves. They had to carry the harvest back in from the fields, all on their own. They drank only water and ate only bread with salt and herbs. They spent their evening in prayer, reading and writing on the teachings of Scripture. Sounds rather like us. The monks were not allowed to own anything. They weren't allowed to own. Even saying my book or my work was considered an offense. They followed a simple life of asceticism, and even on feast days, they didn't eat any meat, but were given leeks as a treat to eat. There you go. It was believed that this is why the leek became Dewi's symbol and one of the symbols of Wales, used later on in the archers' hats to distinguish them from the rest of the forces in the field of battle. This is proved in Henry V, Act 5, Scene 1, when Shakespeare references it. Fluellen says, "If your majesty is remembered of it, the Welshmen did good service in a garden where leeks did grow, wearing leeks in their Monmouth caps, which your majesty knows to this hour is an honorable badge of the service. And I do believe your majesty takes no scorn to wear the leek upon St. Tavy's Day." And King Henry responds, I wear it for memorable honor, for I am Welsh, you know, good countrymen." In around 550 AD, Dewi attended the Synod of Brevi in Llandewi Brevi and spoke out passionately against the heresy of Pelagianism. If you want to know what that is, ask Sarah. She'll tell you all about it. All the monks were gathered, and they were so impressed with him that they elected him the primate of Ceredigion, a huge honor. As such, he presided over the great Synod of Caerleon in AD 589. Where Pelagianism was condemned and any who followed it were thrown out of the church. And that was all started by good old Dewi Sant. My favorite story of Dewi is also his most famous miracle. Again in Llandewi Brevi, he was preaching in the middle of a large crowd, and the people at the back started to complain that they couldn't hear him. And so a white dove landed on his shoulder, and the ground where he was standing began to rise until Dewi was standing on a small hill addressing the crowd, and all could hear him. The Welsh historian John Davis has a wonderful quote about this, and I appreciate it greatly. He says that one can scarcely conceive of a miracle more superfluous in that part of Wales than the creation of a new hill. I love that. St. David died on Tuesday, March the 1st, in either 589 or AD 601. His last words to his followers were, "Ar glwyddi, brodydd a chwiorydd, bod y llawen yn cadwch ei ffydd, a gwnewch y pethau bychain, a glwsoch a welsoch genefi." Which translates, "Lords, brothers and sisters, be joyful and keep your faith, and do the little things that you've seen and heard me do." As he died, the monastery was said to be filled with angels as Christ received his soul. David was canonized by Calixtus II in 1102 AD, and St. David's Day has been celebrated on March the 1st since then. The diarist Samuel Pepys, writing in the 1660s, mentions St. David's Day celebrations in London. And there are recipes from the 18th century in cookbooks for St. David's Day taffies, which are gingerbread figures baked in the shape of Welshmen riding goats. Though the reference to goats is unknown where it comes from. That's a little about St. David. So to you all, a very happy St. David's Day. Dydd Gŵyl Dewi hapus I chi gyd. Sarah, would you please lead us in our prayers?
See if I can do this one any better. Let us join together in prayer on this St. David's Day. There will be a time of silence when we can remember those who we wish to pray for, and then I will lead us in public prayer, and we will end saying the Lord's Prayer. Let us pray. God, our Father, you gave the Saint David to the Welsh Church to uphold the faith and to be an example of Christian perfection. In this changing world, may he help us to hold fast to the values which bring eternal life. May we be joyful in all things. May we keep faith. May we do the little things in Christ's name. We ask this through your Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let us pray as our Savior has taught us in the language of your heart. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Baba will join us for the announcements.
Hello again. Well, here are our announcements. On Thursday, if you're at home and you'd like to join in at 2 o'clock, Sarah's going to be doing a cooking Zoom, and I think it might be something to do with bacon, is it, Sarah? Bacon toast and bacon bread and bacon and more bacon. You can never get enough bacon. And she might just do some ham as well, because we can never get enough bacon and ham. Sunday at 11 o'clock, there is our usual service on YouTube's, with all the links into the all the usual places, and Sarah will be preaching. Then we're very excited that as of the 14th of March, almost a year to the day, we'll be opening the church for public worship every Sunday, and there is no need to pre-register. You'll find out more this Sunday on the service. And obviously, that's subject to the clause 5A, subsection B, subject to change without notice, as is happening in New Zealand as we speak. As I said, there's no need to pre-register, and we look forward from the 14th of March to seeing your smiling faces behind masks. Sarah.
And it's now my pleasure to ask our moderator, Mrs. Christine Boomsma, to say a few words and then to raise the flag for St. David's Day.
Good morning, and well, the microphone is on. Anyway, I'll start again. Bodada, adith gwyl dewi hapus ichigid. Are you right now? Can you hear? Yeah. Ichigid. Good morning, and a very happy St. David's Day to you all. It's lovely to see so many of you have turned out this morning. I know what it's like when you travel into the city, it's awful. But I don't have a lot to say, which I know a lot of people might find that difficult to understand or believe. But every year, the Cambrian Society of Victoria send out over 40 emails to other kindred societies throughout the world. And this year we have received, I think, about 11 so far in return, which is not bad, really. They come from Canada, Edinburgh, Hobart, Canberra, New Zealand, from different places in New Zealand. And they all seem to want us to know how they are celebrating Dydd Gwyl Dewi Sant, St. David's Day, from banquets in New York. Bit different this year because everything has changed, but these in past years they've had banquets and lunches and films and dinners. We've had high tea here, all different things and how they celebrate. But because of the year that we've all had last year, things are different. They're actually sending out recipes to different members in their societies on how to make Welsh cakes and Glamorgan sausages and Barra Briths and all that kind of food that is very Welshy. And of course, in some parts of the world, unable to get together. We're very fortunate this morning that we can come together to celebrate our patron saint. But this year, the email that was sent out, we included greetings from the Melbourne Welsh Church as well. And the reason being is that we thought we could share the virtual Gamanvagane that was on YouTube or whatever you looked at it yesterday, went out. Then everyone in the whole world could actually enjoy the talented people that we have invited to be part of our celebrations in years gone by. All of the people that you saw yesterday have messaged me to wish us all a very happy St. David's Day. And I'm going to name them. The conductors, we've had Geraint and his wife Angela. We've had Dilwyn and his wife Helen. We've had Illid and her husband Dewi. We've had Edward, Chris, and we've also had Rob. Our blue ribbon winners have been Larry and Alad Roberts. We've had Erville and his wife Ebri Llwen. We've had Case and his wife Elonwy. We've had Fionn, we've had Stefan, we've had Andrew, and we've had Alad, Wynne, Davies, and of course Pierce Marion. So how fortunate we have been in the past to have all these wonderful talented people. And the fact that they're in touch with us and we're in touch with them is just a credit to everyone here for their welcome. Now, I was asked to raise the flag, but I think it would be nice if Dillis, who is one of the oldest members present here today of the church and also of the Cambrian Society. So Dillis, would you like to help with raising the flag? Can you come out for me? Yep, thank you. You just come up the stairs here.
There you go. Don't fall. Right. This could be good. Come on, you're over here too.
You first.
Christine, diolch yn fawr. Dilys, thank you very much indeed for doing that. It's a wonderful thing to see. I just want to say a few quick words of thanks to those that have helped today become what it is. To Christine for agreeing to do the flag raising and bringing in her sidekick, Dilys, for doing that. Thank you very much indeed. For the ministry team, just for helping out, for Wendy for playing the organ there, and for our three little Welsh ladies around the front. You're on camera, stand up and turn around. Every year, we have the little Welsh ladies standing there with their little baskets, and we don't really say thank you to them. It's the first opportunity we've actually had this year to say thank you to them. So to you, thank you very much indeed. Every year, you come out looking beautiful, but this year, I don't know whether it's the masks or not, but you look even more beautiful than usual. Sarah, I'm going to move before I say anything I shouldn't say.
Too late. Now I know better. At the end of our final hymn, please stay standing for the blessing and the national anthem of Wales. And then please leave by the side door. If you leave by this side door, please note that there are steps, so we'd prefer you go out this direction instead. Refreshments will be served at the front of the church, and we will now sing our final hymn, Guide Me, O Thou Great Jehovah.
Go, be joyful, keep the faith, and do the little things.
And the blessing of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all.
Brodydd a chwiorydd, byddwch llawen a cadwch eich ffydd, a gnewch y pethau bychain, yn enw Iesu. Amen.